combination one more time. Boys and girls together, don't kill yourselves. Hard. Ready? A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, when I call out your number, I'll tell you where you're going to be in the formation.
Oh, Dad, I don't remember my number.
Right, well, when I come to a number without a person, it's you. First group of girls. Number 2, downstage. Number 9, upstage. Number 10, downstage. Number 23, upstage. Number 23, Judy Turner.
23!
All right, girls, stick left. Second group. Number 37, downstage. Number 60, upstage. Number 63, downstage. Number 45, upstage. Number 81, downstage. And number 84, upstage. All right, boys, stage left. Let's do the ballet combination. First group of girls, second group follow. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Thank you.
shows? Broadway shows. All right, I'm eliminating down. When I call out your number, please form a line. Girls first. Number 2. Number 9. Number 10. Number 23, Judy Turner. All right. 37. 152. 179. 17, number 44, number 45, 63, 67, 81, and 84. Other boys, thank you. I'm sorry. Lori?
Today I want you to tell me your stage name, real name if it's different. And I also would like to know where you were born and when.
Terrific. That's it. Excuse me, sir. Do we have to? I mean, it isn't very polite to ask the lady for age.
Being polite doesn't interest me. Your age does. And I want to know your age. All right, let's go down the line. We'll start on the end of stage right. Start with your name and step forward.
Maggie Winslow.
Louder.
Maggie Winslow! Sometimes known as Margaret, Margie, Peggy, all of the above. Whatever, it's real. And I was born in San Mateo, California on a Thursday evening at 10:40 p.m. August 17th, 1950.
I'm Mike Costa. It used to be Costa Filoni. Born in Trenton, New Jersey, July 9th, 1951. Which makes me 24.
Next.
My real name is Sidney Kenneth Beckenstein. My Jewish name is Rachmella Ben Yochavmeyer Beckenstein. And my professional name is Gregory Gott. Very East Side. And I do not deny. Born August 2nd, 1943.
Sure, go ahead.
No, I mean privately.
Not right now, Cassie. I'm running about an hour behind.
Oh, I know, but I just...
Next.
I'm Sheila Bryant. Really, Sarah Rosemary Bryant, which I really hate. I was born August 8th, 1946, in Colorado City.
Robert Charles Joseph Henry Mills III, and that's my real name too. I come from somewhere upstate near Buffalo. I can't remember the name of the town. I blocked it out. Born March 15th, 1950.
My name is Phoebe Bensenheimer, and I know I gotta change it. Born July 6th, 1949. I come from Boston, and here I am!
Oh. My name is Judy Turner. My real name is Lana Turner. No, it's always been Judy Turner. Born July 21st, 1947. Oh, and I was born in El Paso. El Paso, Texas!
Good.
My name is Richie Walters. I'm from Herculaneum, Missouri. Born on a full moon on June 13th, 1948. And I'm black.
I'm Alan DeLuca. January 11th, 1945. I come from the Bronx.
So, I'm going to ask you some questions, and I want to hear you talk. Treat it like an interview. I don't want you to feel like you have to perform. Just talk and be yourselves. And everybody, just relax as much as you can.
I can't
family. My grandmother was always hanging out the window, leaning on a little pillow. Because that's what Italian grandmothers do. Hang out windows. I was the last of 12. I was an accident.
I was.
That's what my sister told me. Oh, that's the sister Rosalie. She was the one who started taking dance lessons. My mother would take you every Saturday. She used to take me along. I liked going.
How old were you?
4. And I'd sit there all perky and I'm watching Cisco Peter Pan. Said, I can do that. I can do that.
Mother and Dad both gone. 3 by 3 eggs.
know that my dad happened to be this big ex-football hero. He was so humiliated he didn't know what to tell his friends. So, I told them all I had polio. On Father's Day, I limped for him.
Sheila.
Yes? You want me?
Yes.
He wants me.
To talk.
Right. What do you want to know about me first?
Why are you in this business?
Well, I want you to be a prima ballerina. That's awesome. What color is that? Do you have anything?
Don't worry about the lights. Just talk.
Well, like I said, I wanted to be a ballerina because my mother was a ballerina. So my father made her give it up.
Sheila, come downstage. Closer.
Can I sit on your lap?
Do you always come on like this?
No. Sometimes I'm aggressive. Actually, I'm a Leo.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means the other 11 months of the year have to watch out. I'm very strong.
Maybe too strong.
Am I doing something you don't mind? I mean, you told me to be myself.
Just bring it down.
Bring what down?
Your attitude. Tell me about your parents.
My parents.
Your father.
Him.
Your mother.
My mother. My mother was raised like a little nun. She couldn't go out. She couldn't even sing.
Sheila, don't perform. Just talk.
But she wanted to be a dancer, and she had all these scholarships and all that. And when she married my father, he made her give them up. Isn't this exciting? And then she had to stop. Me. And she made her what she wanted to be. And she was fabulous the way she did it. Do you want to know how she did it?
Yes. But first, your hair.
What? You don't like it?
No. Let it down.
That's what I've been trying to do.
Sure. You're strong enough.
Yeah.
Thank you.
get started.
Christine, back in the line. Mark.
Well, I get the feeling most of you always knew what you wanted to do. Me? I didn't. I was just a kid for a while. Oh, then one day, well, you see, my father, he had this fabulous library in the back of the house. And when I was about 11, I guess, I found this medical textbook. It had pictures of the male and female anatomy. Well, I thought that was pretty interesting. I used to read that book a lot.
Were you interested in medicine, or were you just into the pictures?
Oh, no, I...
Changes all now.
discharge, okay? Milky discharge. Milky discharge. Gonorrhea. I was in shock. I mean, gonorrhea. Before it even started, I was terrified. I couldn't tell my mother I had gonorrhea. So the book said drink a lot of water.
Is that all the book said?
No. It said take penicillin, strepto, something or other. But I couldn't do anything about that unless I told somebody. So all I could do was drink the water, and I drank like 20 glasses a day. For 3 weeks, I almost drowned. Finally, I went to confession, and I told the priest that I had gonorrhea. Well, he was in shock too.
Who have you been with, my son?
Nobody.
Then how can you have gonorrhea?
Well, I told him about the book's diagnosis for milky discharge, and he set me straight. It's the only time the church has ever helped me out. Well, I was...
Everybody was my side. Why not pray with everybody?
your father's side of the family, the ugly side.
Thank you. something straight. I never heard about the red shoes. I never saw the red shoes. I didn't give a fuck about the red shoes. I wanted to be a rockhead because this girl in my hometown, Luella Heiner, had actually gotten out and made it to New York. And she was a rockhead. Well, she came home one Christmas to visit. And they gave her a parade. A goddamn parade. Well, I twirled a friggin' baton for 2 hours in the rain. Unfortunately, though, she got knocked up over Christmas. Merry Christmas!
Thank you.
When did you start dancing, Paul?
Not until very late.
Why not?
I don't know why, I just didn't.
Well, then what did you do?
Nothing much.
Oh, come on, Paul, you must have done something. How old were you when you did start dancing?
16.
Well, what did you do up until the time you were 16? I mean, what was your family like?
We were close.
Close. Brothers? Sisters?
Two sisters. One died when I was 14.
How?
I really don't want to talk about that. I mean, why do I have to talk about that?
Lori, can we take a break?
Zach, can the kids please have a break?
And smoke, can the adults please smoke?
All right, everybody take a break. Alcohol. Paul, we'll try this again later. Cassie, stay on stage, please. Two shows cold. Your career was going fine here in New York.
God, sound like my friends, my fans, acting like I'm some star and I don't know it. The truth is, I never came close. No one had the guts to tell me. It would be nice to be a star, but I'm not. I'm a dancer. Give me somebody.
So you're going through a slow period. Something will happen. It happens to everyone.
That's what I kept telling myself in California. And kept telling myself that. And kept telling myself that. Nothing will happen. I can't act.
What?
I can't act. And there I am in California, supposing to be this actress. Well, it didn't take me long to figure out I can't act. Take Hollywood very long either.
You didn't work out there?
Oh, sure. A rotten part, some so-so film. Part ended up getting cut anyway, thank God. I was a go-go dancer in a TV movie of the week. Oh, and commercials. I almost got to squeeze a roll of toilet paper, but I lost out in the finals. Isn't that something? 17 years in the business, and I'm clunked. Toilet paper squeezing. I was a dancing band-aid, that was fun. Then we had an earthquake, and I got a terrific tan. And surely you must have heard about...
I did hear you were going out with some big agent, being a bit wild, running around, carrying on, yeah.
Well, what else is a woman of leisure supposed to do but get a bit wild and carry on? Not to mention getting fat and going crazy. Why I came back to New York, Zach. Which is why I'm here today. Oh dear, little pussycat, I need a job. Do have something that I can believe in. Do have someone to please.
I just can't see you dancing in the chorus, Cassie.
Why not?
Look, if you need some money, call my business manager.
Well, of course I need money. Who doesn't? But I don't need a handout. I need a job. I need a job. I don't know how else to say it. Do you want me to say it again?
No.
You've gotten that far. Look, I have
can't go back to the chorus, Cassie. That's not the answer.
I'm not trying to go back. I'm trying to start over. I'm settled for that. Starting over.
Starting over? We can't.
What? We? You're not talking about...
No, I'm not.
Yes, you were. You were talking about us.
Cassie, let's just keep this business, okay?
By all means, welcome in here for anything else. Isn't that what it's all about? Work? And that's why I'm here today. About work.
Well, you shouldn't have come. You don't fit in. You don't dance like anybody else. You don't know how. Teach them the lyric to that number. Oh, and send Paul in. I really like the way you dance. No, I mean it. So I figured we'd try this again. For one thing, if you're going to change your name, why go from a Puerto Rican one to an Italian one?
Because I don't look it. People say, you don't look Puerto Rican. You don't look Puerto Rican. But I am.
So you figured you looked Italian?
No. I just wanted to become somebody new. So I became Paul San Marco.
Why did you want to become someone new?
Well, not exactly proud of my past.
Who is? But that's what the word means, Paul. Past.
Well, that's easy for you to say.
Look, wait a minute. What made you start dancing, Paul? Your parents?
No. What do Puerto Ricans know about theater? Now they have Channel 47, but then they didn't have anything. But my father left movies. He used to take us all the time. He'd come home from work and we'd go down to 42nd Street. We'd come out of one movie and go into another and another. I don't know why, but I always loved musicals.
How old were you?
7 or 8.
On 42nd Street?
Yeah, it was a trip.
Go on.
And I'd have to move down front because I couldn't see. But I wear contact lenses now. And I'd move down front. These strange men would come sit next to me and play with me. But I never told anybody because I guess it didn't matter.
Why didn't it matter?
I don't know why. It just did.
Look, Paul, if this is too rough for you, I have your picture and resume.
No, no. Okay. From seeing all those movie musicals, I used to dance around the street. I get caught all the time. God, it was embarrassing. I was always being Citrice. Always. I really don't understand because I always wanted to be an actor. I mean, I really wanted to perform. Well, once my cousin said, "You'll never be an actor." Well, I know she was saying this because I was such a sissy. I mean, I was terribly effeminate. I always knew that I was gay, but that didn't bother me. What bothered me was that I didn't know how to be a boy. One day I looked in the mirror and I said, "You're 14 years old and you're a faggot. What are you going to do for the rest of your life?" Well, by that time I was in Cardinal Hayes High School. There were about 3,000 boys there. I had no protection anymore. There was no homeroom where I could be charming and funny with the tough guys so they'd fight my battles for me like when I was in small schools. I liked school, but my grades got so bad. Even if I knew the answer to a question, I wouldn't raise my hand because I was scared that they would laugh at me. They'd even whistle at me in the halls. God, it was awful. Just awful. Well, finally, I went down.
1962, and at the age of 15, you just didn't say that.
So he said to me, well, I think you should see a psychologist. And I did. And he said, well, I think you're very well adjusted for your age and that you should quit school. So I did. Well, I really didn't want to, but I just couldn't take it anymore. You see, when I quit school, what I was trying to do was figure out who I was and how to be a man. You know, there are a lot of people in this world who don't know how to be men. Since then, I found out that I am one. See, I was looking for the wrong thing. I was trying to learn how to be butch. Well, anyway, I started hanging out around 72nd Street, meeting all these really strange people. Just trying to make friends that were like me, so I could understand what it was that I was. Well, somebody told me they were looking for male dancers at the Jewelbox Revue. You know, the drag show. So I go down to the audition. And from all these years of pretending that I was Sid Charisse, I had this fabulous extension. I mean, I could turn anything, my first audition. So they said to me, well, you're too short to be a boy. Would you like to be a pony? And I said, what's that? They said, a girl. A girl? What do I have to do? Show us your legs. But I've got hair on my legs. Well, that's all right, come on upstairs. And they took me upstairs and they hiked up my dungarees and put on a pair of nylon stockings and high heels. It was freaky. It was incredible. So I went back downstairs and they said, wow, you have wonderful legs. I said, really? Terrific. That is so strange thinking about all of this. It was a whole lifetime ago. I was just past 16. Anyway, then there was this thing about me trying to hide it from my parents. Well, that was something, because I had to buy all this stuff, like shoes to rehearse in and earrings and makeup. And I would hide it all, and my mother would find it. Well, I told her there was this girl on the show, and that she didn't want her mother to find out what she was doing, and that I was holding this stuff for her. She believed me. Well, I was finally in show business. It was the asshole of show business, but it was a job. Nothing to brag about. I had friends. But after a while, it all got so demeaning. I mean, nobody at the Jewel Box had any dignity. And most of them just considered themselves freaks. I don't know, I guess it was the lack of dignity that got to me. So I left. I muddled around for a while. Well, I worked as an office boy and a waiter. But without an education, you can't get a good job. So when the Jewel Box called and asked if I'd come back, I went. Well, we were working at the Apollo Theater up on 125th Street, doing four shows a day with a movie. It was really tacky. The show was going to Chicago, and my parents wanted to say goodbye. And they were going to bring my luggage down to the theater after the show. Well, we were doing this Oriental number, and I looked like Anna May Wong. I mean, I had these two great big chrysanthemums on either side of my head, and this huge headdress with gold balls hanging all over it. Well, I was going off to the finale, when who do I see standing by the stage door? My parents. They got there too early. I freaked, I didn't know what to do. I thought to myself, okay, just take a deep breath and rush quickly past them and they'll never recognize you. I took a deep breath. Just as I started down the stairs, I heard my mother say, oh my God. Well, I died. I didn't know what to do. I had to go on for the finale, so I just kept going. After the show, I went back to the dressing room. And after I'd finished dressing and taking off my makeup, I went back downstairs. And there were my parents, just standing in the middle of all these... And all they said to me was, please write, and make sure you eat and take care of yourself. And just before my parents left, my father turned to the producer and he said, you take care of my son. That was the first time he ever called me that.
you just learned. Now listen, this is important. I want to see unison dancing. Every head, arm, body angle exactly the same. You must blend. This is one of those numbers where you back the star. You're her frame. I don't want to catch anybody pulling my eye, got it? All right, let's review it. Starting position is turned in third. Hips and shoulders on the diagonal. Elbows up, chest up, chin up, eyes front. Ready? A 5, 6, 7, 8. One, change. Walk, walk. Point and point and point, flick, step, kick. Okay, let's do it again from singular sensation. Point and point and point, flick, step, kick. One, continuing. Walk, walk. Up, down, up, down. Make it sharp. Step, brush, step, brush, step, brush. Back, 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 and. Lunge, lunge, slow, 3, 4, 5, 6. Whip, step, brush, hit the arm, back, back, and.
Thank you.
Cassie.
Singular sensation.
Because that's what you expected, huh?
Start matching them up. Do the tap combination.
Okay!
Is that better?
Does anybody have
get them up. Easy. Count of three. Ready? One, two, three. All up. Easy, easy.
Where's Ben's back?
Which is his back?
All right, boys, take my back. No. Paul, I'll see you later. Glory, call me from the hospital.
Enjoy giving.
Right. But if today were the day you had to stop dancing, how would you feel?
But I can't rest.
Before I start eliminating, I just want to say I think you're all terrific. You've been really wonderful about going through all of this today. I sincerely wish I could hire each one of you, but I can't. Will the following people please step forward? Greg. Al. Deanna. No, I'm wrong. Back in line. Christine. Bebe. Sheila. Maggie. Frontline, thank you very much. Thank you. I'm sorry. Rehearsals begin September 22nd. You'll be rehearsing for 6 weeks with a 2-month out-of-town tryout. Our New York opening will be sometime mid-January. Be prepared to sign a standard minimum contract with a 6-month rider. You'll be contacted next week sometime as to where and when to sign your contract. And I'm very glad we're going to be working together.